The boys were in the floor over there. Darley was on the sofa by the window.
It was a grim narration in an even darker setting. It was once a beautiful home. Now it sits empty, walls still stained with signs of violence. A relative of Darley Routier recounted what the family says happened the night of June 6th. They say a stranger slipped into the home through a garage window.
He came into this house, slaughtered these children, and tried to kill Darley. When she remembers coming to, says she saw him going out the back door. She raised up off the sofa, and she saw him going out that way through the kitchen.
Randy Reagan is an in-law of Darley Routier. He walked us through the Routier home, past the murder scene, then upstairs where Darley's husband Darren and their infant son Drake were allegedly asleep at the time of the murders. He says Darren woke to Darley's screams.
She came in here and was screaming at him, and he came down the stairs to hear, and then, of course, ran in here, and the boys ran here on the floor. He ran by Damon. He didn't see Damon first. He saw Devin laying over there, and Damon was against the wall. He never saw him.
Authorities believe Darley stabbed her sons to death and, to cover it, wounded herself at the kitchen sink, leaving blood on the counter. Her family says blood was on the counter because she was trying to help the boys, not kill them.
Where she reached, pulled the drawer open, got the towels out, came over to the sink and wet the towels, and that's why there's blood all over here.
But investigators say it appears someone tried to wipe the blood off the counter, and they question why an unknown murderer would do that. They also contend that there is no evidence of an intruder, that even the dust on the windowsill was undisturbed. Randy Reagan disagrees.
You don't have to touch the window or anything else to get in and out of it.
There is newer evidence that will have an unknown effect on this case. Test results from a bloody sock found in the alley a few homes down from the Routier's house. Initial testing showed it had blood from both boys on it, a spot no bigger than a quarter, and hair from a deer. Now sources say the latest results show more DNA was found on that sock, DNA that belongs to Darley Routier. Most of Routier's immediate family remains under a gag order. An exception is Darley's sister, Danelle Stahl.
I talk to Damon and Devin every night and tell them to help their mommy and to find the guy that did this and to point it out to the police and to our lawyers and to the people that are looking for him.
Sources say those involved with the case on both sides have been so torn by the tragedy that many are seeking counseling to help them deal with the violent deaths of two young boys. Joe Munoz, Texas News 5.